Ollie Canning in Portumna here. There's a few signs of a bit of support for the Galway team here, a bit of bunting about. How much of a buzz is there in the county?
Yeah, it's really building, I think, now the last week or so. We're getting more phone calls for tickets and stuff like that. So it is starting to build, and I think, for the next week, people are really looking forward to the game and just hoping that Galway can do the business on September 9th.
And how keen are Galway to try and keep a lid on all that?
Yeah, it's very important. I think it's critical for the management team, I suppose, to try and keep the guys focused on training this week now on the run-up to the game. There will be a lot of media coverage and, analysing, team tactics and all the rest. So, it's up to the players, I suppose, just to try and keep their feet on the ground and just concentrate on what they have to do, on the day.
Well, let's talk about team tactics then. How are Galway going to play this when the surprise element is gone from the last time against Kilkenny? How do they play it this time?
Well, I mean, I don't know. I'm sure Anthony Cunningham probably has, maybe a tactic or two that they're going to try and implement the next day. But Kilkenny, obviously, will have looked at the Leinster final probably a couple of times at this stage, to see where they went wrong on the day. And, they'll be trying to counteract Galway tactics. And, Kilkenny more or less play a straightforward game. They usually go just 15 on 15. You don't get, too much else from Kilkenny. That's the way they like to play hurling. And it's proved very effective for them. So I suppose why change? But Galway will have to probably, have a couple of tactics up their sleeve for Sunday.
Having said that, there was a bit of debate recently about whether there are any tactics in hurling, whether you just go out and you just play.
Well, look, generally it's going to come down to every man trying to win his position, and as a whole then, as a team, then you should win the game if the majority of your players win their personal battle with their opponent. But it's going to be down to work rate. I think Galway showed a massive work rate in the Leinster final, and that was really the key for Galway that day. And if they can bring the same work rate to the game the next day, they'll have a good chance. But Kilkenny will be trying to do that as well. Kilkenny were always known for savage high work rate, especially from their forwards as well. It's very, very difficult to clear a ball, when you're playing against Kilkenny. So, both teams will be trying to bring that to the table on September 9th,
Well, where do you stand on the debate about Kilkenny then? Do you think they were just caught the last time? Do you think they're maybe on the wane?
I'm not too sure. I mean, they look to be back to their best, in the second half, especially against Tipperary the last day. There was a number of factors. JJ Delaney has come back in. Michael Finnelly was missing that day in the Leinster final. He's a big loss. Michael Rice, I know he's missing the next day as well. But, there was a number of key players that Kilkenny were missing that day. And, they didn't look to be on form that day. But, saying that, Galway played very, very well. And for long periods in that game, Galway made them look, second best to nearly every ball. And, that's something that Galway will try and bring to the table. But Kilkenny, I suppose, they're going to get huge motivation from that game as well. Brian Cody will be telling these guys that, Galway have beaten you once and it's not going to happen again this year, basically. And that's the way they're going to approach it. So it's going to be very interesting, on the day.
The revenge factor.
Well, definitely, maybe not revenge factor, but it will definitely be motivation for Kilkenny the next day because, they don't like to get beaten. And, Galway beat them fairly well the last day. So, they'll be using that for motivation. But on the other hand, I suppose Galway can take good confidence from the win, in the Leinster final. And, they know that they can beat Kilkenny and hopefully they'll be trying to do that the next day again.
I was going to ask for your gut feeling, but I know your heart probably says Galway. What does your head say? What does your gut say?
Well, I definitely think, Galway have a great chance. I think they need to bring, a huge work rate to the game, minimise the mistakes. And a key area, I feel, is the, Kilkenny beat Tipperary the last day getting goals. They just punched holes in the Tipperary back line. And if Galway can minimise the goal chances for Kilkenny the next day, they'll go a long way to having a good chance of winning the game. But again, they're going to have to bring a huge work rate, a huge, huge motivation to the game. And it's all new for Galway too. Kilkenny, on the other hand, a huge experience in All-Ireland final days. And a lot of the Galway players, I suppose, it's going to be their first All-Ireland senior final in Croke Park. And hopefully it's going to be a good day anyway.
And how big a factor is that? It's 24 long years. It's been too long. But, what will it do for this place, for example, if they win?
It would give Galway a huge lift. I mean, a lot of people think it is too long to go for a team like Galway to not win the All-Ireland. But, down through the years, we've probably seen in the last decade Kilkenny, who are probably one of the best teams that ever lined out on a hurling field. So there was lots of factors. There was lots of good teams out there in that time. But, Galway hopefully can get one over on Kilkenny. It will be a great day. It will be great for the county.
and great for the family. We haven't mentioned Joe, but obviously you'll be wanting him to win in All-Ireland, but I'm sure he's trying to keep his feet on the ground too.
Yeah, Joe is, and all the guys are, with Joe and Damien Hayes and the club here, Portumna, and Andy Smith, you know, the guys are playing very well this year. So we're just hoping, keeping our fingers crossed for the lads, that, you know, they'll be able to put in good performances and contribute to, hopefully, a Galway victory on Sunday.